As we bring a close to another year and face a new year, it's my delight today to be talking to a friend of many of ours, a good friend of mine, Dr. George Wood. I'm confident that our conversation today will not only be inspirational, but there will be a lot of practical insights that will be of great blessing to you. Dr. Wood, thanks for taking the time to chat. You are deeply, deeply loved by this fellowship. Can you give us an update to your health and where you're at?
Well, Doug, first of all, thanks to you for making this moment available. I was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer on August 30th. It was a tumor in the esophagus, and it had spread to the liver and one of my vertebrae. And I went through several rounds of chemotherapy and a clinical trial drug, but the third round with the clinical trial drug had some very severe side effects, which ended up with me being in Barnes Hospital in St. Louis for 16 days, and then transferred here to a manor in Springfield for rehab. I did not realize that if you go 16 days in a bed, you lose your ability to be mobile. So I've had to learn to walk again and all that kind of thing. But
You couldn't tell that coming down here. You were
With a walker, I can do okay. You know? There are things that happen in life that you don't ever anticipate. And certainly cancer was not on my radar screen at all.
Sure. Well, this fellowship is continuing to pray for you and believing for a full recovery. You know, George, I know of your great love for the scripture and the word of God. And has there been some scriptures that have really anchored your heart and emotions during this time?
You know, one of my very favorite passages is Psalm 84, where it says, "Blessed are those who set their hearts on pilgrimage, who passing through the valley of Baca, which is a desert place, make it a well." And then that great phrase, "They go from strength to strength until each appears before God in Zion." And we're all actually headed to Zion at one point or another. And I found that in the moments in my life when I have been the weakest physically, which has been the last few months, I have felt the strongest spiritually. And I have felt anew what the Apostle Paul said, that when I am weak, then I am strong. It's been really an amazing experience, Doug. Right from the moment I got the diagnosis on August 30th, 2 days before my 80th birthday, by the way, nice birthday present, right? I felt an instant peace. And I've said to people, I've said this to nurses, I've said this to doctors, you know, as a follower of Jesus, I have two great options. I can go home to my home in Springfield, or I can go to my home in heaven. And I like both, you know, so it goes either way. And this coming from a guy who all my life was afraid of death, you know, it just spooked me out as a kid, you know, the idea of death. And of course, as a pastor dealing with dying and dealing with funerals, but I never quite got over that. But this time when it affects me personally, and I don't know what the final outcomes are gonna be, I've just had this great sense, the Lord is with me. I've been in the Lord's hands all my life, and He's with me now. And I'm passing through this desert place, but I go from strength to strength, until we all appear someday before God in Zion. You'll be years after me, whether it's this year or next year, who knows what for me, but you know, I'm really at peace. I just want to, one word beyond that is that it's important that my experience, there's somebody that's going through a similar experience, that they don't universalize my experience to think what I'm going through has to apply to them.
Right.
Because everybody processes things differently.
Yes.
But the Lord has helped me process it in the way that I'm processing it.
I have so many Georgisms that I draw into my life, and one of them that you said often is faith is not dependent on favorable circumstances. And that's what I hear you saying in this